Well, I'm proud of you.
A November day in Wales, and I've joined a Dutch and Belgian party to shoot driven pheasants. While we get ourselves ready, the team of beaters are on the way to the start of the first drive. Most of them are regulars and look forward to the day out as much as the guns do.
7.
It's a bad start.
Is it?
It's not that bad.
Shoot organizer John Ransford makes the draw, which gives each gun his position in the line. After each drive, you move up 2 places.
We're trying to fix it so that I got the best stand.
Yeah, number one.
Who've I missed?
Was a disaster today.
Who've I missed? Sorry, Harry. Must be a good one. Must be a good one.
That's a good start, number 2.
It is. Right, can we load up? We're going to the mount for the first drive.
There are a lot of people involved in a deer's pheasant shooting. Besides the 8 guns, there are about 20 others doing various jobs necessary to providing a day's sport.
Come on, come up.
This is ideal country for pheasant shooting. Rolling wooded hills and open valleys. The guns stand on the low ground and the pheasants fly high over them as they're driven from one wood to another. The drive started now, so it won't be long till the first birds appear. The beaters line out across the wood and work their way slowly towards us, pushing the pheasants ahead of them.
How many days shooting do you do?
We do 35 here.
35?
Yes.
And you were telling me 30,000 pheasants?
That's right. Yeah. But they're so well spread over, you know, this estate and the other estate that I have, that, you know, the numbers aren't indecent. I mean...
So you don't have to repeat the drives every day?
No, you're somewhere else every day? We can do 14 days without overlapping.
The beaters are trying to drive the pheasants out in ones and twos, so they take it steady. There could be hundreds of birds in this wood, and they don't want them all to fly out at the same time. There's the first one, and it's dead. And another, and it's got away. Some of the birds are too low, so we'll leave them alone. But there are some real high ones as well. My one chance, and I didn't ruffle a feather. I'm at the wrong end of this drive.
Okay. We're back in the vehicles again. You see?
I had a very high one.
I saw
one
of
them. William, you make the show, it's always good.
You took a little time to get the hang of it, but then you got right into the...
Excuse me, warm.
That far in.
It's difficult, you know, to judge. Holland is so flat. And when you see high birds here, it's amazing.
Yeah, you think they're out of sight.
Yes, yeah. Just like that, you know. Little crosses in the sky.
One woodcock. Thank you very much.
That means you bought the first drinks. Yeah. Did you buy the first drinks?
Yeah.
Did you bring money along? Yeah, because you're around.
Every year, up to 10 million pheasants are shot in Britain. About half of these are wild, and the rest are specially reared in the spring and released in the summer. Wild pheasants don't always breed successfully in this country, except in some favoured areas like Norfolk. Of the pheasants that are released, about 50% are shot, and the rest live on in the wild or are killed by foxes. They used to say, up goes a pound, bang goes sixpence, and down comes five bob. Now it's more like, up goes 10 pound, the cost of rearing a bird, bang goes 10 pence, the cost of a carriage, and down comes 150, the price the game dealer pays for his pheasants. So you can see that it's an expensive game. Anything from £100 per person per day, depending on the bag, and at the end of the day, each gun gets just one brace of birds. The rest go to market.
I can't remember being on a better shoot for standing your guns. The way down below the woods, every bird you're going to get is going to be pretty... You can be pretty selective on them here.
Yeah, and you'll see all day, all the drives we do today, the emphasis on quality.
Yeah. And really, the idea of it is not to shoot as many pheasants as you can, but to shoot...
To shoot the ones you enjoy.
The ones you enjoy.
Yeah.
That's a good way of putting it, Dad.
The first birds on this second drive should appear soon, so the pickers up get into position behind the guns. These men use their dogs, usually retrievers, to pick up all the shot birds which fall around them. They leave dead birds till the drive is over, but wounded ones are picked up immediately.
You can imagine in 70 days shooting, the spin-off into that community.
That's right.
And, this year, particularly, we've had tremendous requests from the overseas people, several parties of Americans already, this Dutch party who've been coming for 7 or 8 years, and also still to come a party of Germans and several more of Americans.
What people don't appreciate how big an industry shooting is in this
they
country.
Don't, they don't. One of the big disappointments is that we are very bad in this country at utilising our game as food. Most of the venison and most of the pheasants go to France and Germany. Very low prices too. This is mainly brought about by the birds that are shot in East Europe, Hungary and Czechoslovakia, and they, whatever we charge for pheasants, they're going to undercut us every time. This is you, Jack. Keep him below them. This is you. Got it?
Oops, sorry.
All right. I'm used to that. Have a go. You got it. Good shot.
Any amount of birds.
It's been warm, that one.
That's right. I mean, how many of the people have you?
Here with walking gun.
We hope to get 6 drives in today, weather permitting, so there's no hanging about. As soon as one drive is over, we're into the Land Rovers and away to the next one.
Most shoots have 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 famous drives. We probably have a dozen or 20 here because the terrain is such that we can put the guns well below in the valleys, or we stand them in rides where you've got timber from 60 to 120 feet high.
Yes. I'm not going to see these birds until they're probably 75 yards away.
Yeah.
And by that time, they're coming downhill, downwind, and they're going to be going pretty quick. And they're going to be fairly high.
The gliding pheasant is the most difficult of all. It's on set wings, and it's dropping often. You're losing quite a lot of altitude, and most people shoot behind them. They don't realise that a bird of a cock pheasant of 3.5 pounds, when he's got his wings set, is travelling exceedingly fast.
Oh, aye. I know that. I like them quick, though. I prefer them quick to slow.
Yeah.
So, let's go through it again. High pheasants, weight on the front foot, 60 degrees, and then
emphasize
the weight as you go.
Yes, sir.
I'll try and remember that. The trouble is you get excited, you see, and when you get excited, you don't think about what you're supposed to be doing when you're shooting. Yes.
I've noticed that most people who play ball games, good cricketers, good tennis players, presumably good footballers, that have a sense of timing, are good shots, naturally good shots.
I'm not bad. I'm not a good shot. Not by some of the people I've shot with, but standards, but by the average, I'm not bad. It's terrific when you get forestry like that goes hand in hand with shooting.
That's
so
right.
That the forests are laid out actually for shooting.
There is very good relationship between the forestry and the shooting here. You know, we realise that the forestry has got to go on and trees have got to be felled and thinned, and we have this very good relationship that keeper and head forester work together.
I mean, you can tell. It's a habit you get into when you do shoot. You drive through the countryside, and whenever you see something laid out, you say, that's laid out for shooting. And the wife will say, how do you know? And I say, because of the way the woods lead from one to the other, and where you can imagine the guns would stand,
yeah,
and the way they come to a point where there may be the flushing point. And you can tell, just yeah, by the layout of it, how yeah, it was done, that when they were laid, the people were interested in shooting.
That's right. But hunting and shooting have done more for conservation and landscaping than any other thing, any other group of people. You know, when hunting became, fox hunting particularly, became, you know, such a renowned sport in this country, the hunting people, the landowners, planted woods in sheltered places, often on the tops of hills, yeah, where they got long gallops away.
Which was ideal for
yeah,
them.
And to people who come from overseas, the country is quite striking. You know, when I've been to Europe and other places, there's an awful lot of the same. Come on.
That's the way you jerk me into.
I will.
See, you're dreaming again, there.
Yeah.
Should have been loaded up and ready again.
Heard a lovely American expression the other day. Can we have loaders? No, you can't have loaders, but we want a team of stuffers then.
Stuffers. That's the people I send behind.
That's stuffer. Right. I'm a stuffer.
You're a stuffer. At the moment, you're a stuffer.
Well, that was another poor stand for me. I got nothing at all. But you've got to take it as it comes. I'm gradually moving up the line, and I should get into a hot spot soon. It's a testing time for headkeeper Peter Dennison. This is his first season on this estate. He's been racing around everywhere, making sure that everything is going well. He needn't worry. This is one of the best organized shoots I've ever been on.
During the 1981 winter, which was one of the coldest we've had for many years and went on for a very long time, the contribution that the gamekeepers and the shooting made to wildlife was enormous. In the feed areas where we feed the pheasants, in certain places, and particularly around the headkeeper's house, there were thousands of the small songbirds.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure if you put down as much feed as you do a year, that everything else must make
That's
a benefit
right.
from
That's
it.
That's right. The two estates, it's £100,000.
That's what it cost you,
That's
the
cost
rear.
Me, yes.
£100,000, so you've got to get that, recoup that in your shooting.
That's right. That's right. That's a real gamble.
And it's really pretty. When you think about it, it really is a bit of a short season because you wouldn't start until...
We don't start until November.
Till November. Yeah. See, in November, December, January.
It's terribly intense. I mean, it's every day from the 1st of November until the 1st of February. Dead. Sit. Hang on, bring it round.
I'm over my right shoulder consistently.
Yeah. You're not turning round.
I was in a hot spot there. I got a lot of shooting, and I wasn't alone. The other guns got plenty as well. You certainly had some spectacular ones in these first two drives.
No, thank you very much. It's a nice compliment, but you probably don't have seen how many I missed.
It doesn't matter, that's half the fun.
Well, it's a sport, and I hope that everybody let the low birds fly and keep them up for the next year or for a better season.
So you would have been unfortunate on that drive. Most of the birds swung back very quickly along the edge of the wood and a bit low for you.
Yes. I wouldn't shoot them.
No, they were a bit dangerous and were a bit low and a bit quick.
Well, she's an absolutely safe gun. She wouldn't shoot low, and I'm very proud of her because I trained her myself, and so far she didn't make mistakes.
You had one or two good birds early on.
Well, the main thing is, if you have one or two good birds, you should be very pleased and then leave the easy one to go. That's the way to do it. Make it sporty.
It's right? Nice to hear people from the continent talking like that, because people from the continent tend to have a bad name over here for shooting everything that moves.
Yeah, well, you shouldn't except do that, beaters. But
except beaters, of course.
Except beaters. Only when they fly.
Lunch break now, and a count of the bag. We've got 168. A good morning.
Dory. Kijk eens hier met de wind moest ze draaien, hè?
Dat is mooi hoor.
Oké, fantastisch.
Not fantastic for me, but it was good for some. These foreign guns are good shots. They've all shot all over the continent, and they seem very impressed by the quality of British shoots. We seem to have preserved our field sports as well, if not better, than anyone else in Europe, which is amazing on such a crowded little island. Last drive, and the light's going fast.
Come on, good job, come on, come on.
And that is the end of that. Final bag, 254. A good day.
That was a wonderful drive.
It was, wasn't it?